Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this exercise, we are going to determine the shape of the trajectory of a particle moving in the xy plane. Write the expressions of the velocity vector, acceleration vector, and the speed of the particle. Determine the magnitude of the tangential acceleration. Determine the radius of curvature of the trajectory at a certain instant. Draw the position vector, the velocity vector, and the acceleration on the trajectory.
Consider a particle moving on a curved path in the xy plane. We draw the trajectory of the particle during the first 6 seconds. This is the position vector of the particle. Number one, determine the shape of the trajectory. The position vector is of the form xi plus yj. So, x equals minus 2t, then t equals minus x over 2. Now, replace t in the expression of y by minus x over 2, you get this equation. Hence, the trajectory equation is y equals x squared minus 4x plus 1. The trajectory equation is of the form y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are constants. Therefore, the shape of the trajectory is a parabola.
Number 2. Determine the expressions of the velocity and the acceleration vectors of m. Given that, if x equals at, where a is a constant, then x prime equals a. And if x equals at to the power n, where a and n are two constants, then the derivative of x with respect to time equals nat to the power n minus 1. The velocity is given by the derivative of the position vector with respect to time, r equal xi plus yj, so v equal x prime I plus y prime j. X equal minus 2t, then x prime equal minus 2. Y equal 4t squared plus 8t plus 1, then y prime equal 8t plus 8. Now, let's determine the expression of the acceleration of m. A is given by the time derivative of the velocity. So, v equal vxi plus vyj. Vx equal minus 2 and vy equal 8t plus 8. The derivative of vx with respect to time equals 0, and the derivative of vy with respect to time equals 8, then a vector equal 8j in meter per second squared. Now, number 3. Determine the expression of the speed of the particle. The speed is given by the square root of the x component of the velocity squared plus the y component of the velocity squared. Knowing that vx equal minus 2 and vy equal 8t plus 8, then v equal the square root of minus 2 squared plus 8t plus 8 squared. This is going to be v equal the square root of 64t squared plus 128t plus 68 in SI units.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 4. For time 1 second, determine the magnitude of the tangential acceleration. You know that the magnitude of the tangential acceleration is equal to the time derivative of the speed. If x equals the square root of u, then the time derivative of x equals the time derivative of u over 2 times the square root of u. Look at the expression of the speed. This is u. Then you get this expression. Therefore, at equals 64t plus 64 over the square root of 64t squared plus 128t plus 68. Now, we want the tangential acceleration at time 1 second. So, we will replace t in the expression of at by 1. You get this expression. Therefore, the tangential acceleration at time 1 second equals 128 over the square root of 260 meters per second squared, or 7.9 meters per second squared.
4.2. For time 1 second, determine the magnitude of the normal acceleration. We proved that in the previous slides, the acceleration vector equals 8j, and the tangential acceleration at time 1 second equals 128 over the square root of 260 meters per second squared. We know that the acceleration vector equals the tangential acceleration vector plus the normal acceleration vector. Since AT and AN are perpendicular to each other, then the magnitude of the acceleration vector squared equals the magnitude of the tangential acceleration squared plus the magnitude of the normal acceleration squared. A vector equals ATJ, so the magnitude of A equals 8. AT of 1 equals 128 over the square root of 260. So AT of 1 squared equals 128 squared over 260. Then AN at T equals 1 equals 1 meter per second squared.
Let's move to part 4.3. For time 1 second, determine the radius of curvature of the path followed by m at this instant. You know that the magnitude of the normal or the radial acceleration equals v squared over r. To calculate the radius of curvature at time 1 second, we need to calculate the speed at time 1 second. So, replace t in the expression of the speed by 1. You get this expression. Therefore, the speed at time 1 second equals the square root of 260 meters per second, which is equal to 16.1 meters per second. We already have the normal acceleration at time 1 second. Therefore, plugging in the numbers gives you r equals 260 meters.
Number 5. Draw the trajectory of m and show on it the position vector, velocity vector, and acceleration vector at time 1 second. We proved in the previous slides the expressions of the position vector are the velocity vector v and the acceleration vector a. This figure shows the trajectory of m during the first 6 seconds. To draw the position vector, velocity vector, and the acceleration vector at time 1 second, we have to determine the expressions of these vectors at time 1 second. To determine r of 1, just replace t by 1 second in the expression of r. So r of 1 equals minus 2i plus 13j. R of 1, or the origin of r of 1, is the origin of the coordinates, and r of 1 ends at a point having an abscissa minus 2 and an ordinate 13 meters. So r1 is drawn on the figure. Now, let's determine the expression of V of 1. To determine V of 1, just replace T by 1 second in the expression of V. So V of 1 equals minus 2i plus 16j. The origin of V of 1 is the position of M at time 1 second. Or, the origin of V of 1 is the end of R of 1. And V of 1 is tangent to the trajectory at point M at time 1 second. So V of 1 is drawn on the figure. Now, A of 1 equals 8j at any instant. The origin of A of 1 is the end of R of 1. Since A of 1 has a positive component along the y-axis, so A of 1 is directed vertically upward.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.